Okay, we're going to put this hose dispenser on the wall just there. This is the bracket. So we've got two anchor points at the top and one at the bottom. It's not ideal. It's about the positioning. You can go middle of the brick, so the brick won't blow out when you drill the holes. However, on the bottom you'll be meeting the sand and cement. So that's not ideal because, you know, admittedly, the most important anchor points are the top, right? Because it's the weight goes down that way. However, we can position it like halfway, even out the top and the bottom on that course of bricks and this course of bricks. We don't really pick up enough brick. The bottom of it could blow out. We might be okay if we angle it up a bit. We angle the fixing screw up a bit. They recommend 80 centimeters up from the ground. Okay, I've got my position. So that's where it's going, but I have to make marks, so I've got this pen here. I'm going to put paint on that, I'm going to stick it through the hole, and then I'll be able to see where I've got to drill. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to start off with the smallest drill bit, and I'm going to choose one of these and work my way up to the second biggest, and then size up from that. And then hopefully, if I can find the right one, then that'll be the fourth drill bit I use. And by stepping up the hole sizes, there's less chance of the brick blowing out. Okay, unfortunately, that drill wasn't powerful enough, and this was too powerful. So I'll try another technique where I just don't put as much pressure on the brick. Okay, next size up. Okay, another size up. And another one. Okay, and we got him. So that's it. Okay, we got it now. Now what I need to do is make a few indentations so the drill bit doesn't move when we start to drill it out. Okay, I'll work on that a little bit longer. Okay, I'll start drilling. The secret is the first one. Once you got that, the others will follow. So I'll make a start now. Okay, we're in our second drill bit. Okay, third drill bit. Okay, last drill bit. Okay, I'm just going to wash any excess dust out of the holes. So the main thing to consider here is don't place too much pressure on the drill. Otherwise, you can blow out the back of the brick you're working on, and just take it easy with the first one, and hopefully the machine you've got isn't too heavy, and it's strong enough, you know, and or just right. And okay, well anyway, we'll put the plugs in now. It could possibly be a little bit tight. I'm thinking I might just try and make that a bit bigger. Okay, so I'm going to screw the screw down, but I'm not going to pull that in too far back, so back it off a bit. Put it in. So it's bottoming out, so I'll bring it back a bit. And I'll use a punch to get the sleeve back in a bit. Okay, so this one went in on a bit of an angle, so I'm expecting to have to get the hammer out and adjust them a bit. See what we've got. Yep. Yeah, it's got to come down a bit.
see how that goes. Yep, job done. Okay, well, it's not a perfect design. This does come out on a V or a wedge shape bracket here, and we've got a 45 degree angle finish here, so of course it's not going to swivel or have the full travel that it should, but you know, it's okay. Oh, that's good. Where I work, they had one of these put on, and what I like about it is it doesn't take much for it to stop and then go again, you know. It's reliable too. Long term, I don't know. The one at work is new, but you know, that's a good start. Whatever you do, don't get this sort of hose reel. Okay. I cannot recommend this. Can I recommend that Serta? Not yet, because I haven't used it long enough. And I haven't had any experience with aged Serta hose reels. But we've had these for about 7 years. My mum busted up her shoulders. You know, you can pull them out, but they won't stop, and you can wrestle with them, but they keep on trying to get the hose back in. Very heavy springs. I undid this one to try and adjust it, but it just kept on unraveling, and eventually the spring went. So, you know, look, the best way that I can describe it is, please like and subscribe. Okay, so beware the devil. There's always something, right? And this is it here. That's the inlet, so that comes off, and the hose connects to that and goes to the tap. However, you know, as you can imagine, it's only going to go so far back toward the wall. So let's have a look. Funnily enough, the hose that they supplied, it doesn't really, I think that's just going to pop off, you know. It's not really, but anyway, the travel, it's only going to go to about there, but the, you know, I mean, that's okay, right? But just as another side point, this I must be seeing things. Hang on.
And this doesn't seem to be interchangeable. It does have a cap, but that's only for the running mechanism, which works very well. But okay, maybe it does work after all. So yeah, you have to put unusual amount of pressure on it and it'll click. Okay, so turn it on. Okay, all right, all good. But that's, I think you can get ones that they'll fold against the wall, but that's okay. Okay, false alarm. Yeah, well, okay. Okay, this is the way that this goes up, and Pope has the pipe coming down round out the bottom. So that, that will, you know, it'll fold, and it can also be a straight out dispenser, so Pope was certainly thinking there. Okay, good on you, Pope. Okay, so the whole thing about that design is you have robustness and strength around the fitting, so I can see the design now. So your tap will need to be on the left hand side. In this case, that just happens to be the way that the setup is. So, and it'll fold back far enough. It is much better to have the outlet coming out down there so it can go that way or that way. But okay, lucky, all good.